Concerns mount over the availability of food products due to the month-long Luzon-wide lockdown. Joining us now for more is San Miguel Food and Beverage President Butch Alejo. Butch, good to have you on. Welcome to the program.
Thank you, Kathy.
So what's it like over the past 5 days since the lockdown from a logistics and supply chain management perspective?
Well, for a while, we had some problems in deliveries, as you know, because the checkpoints were hampering deliveries of the food items. But I have to say that lately, especially in the last couple of days, things have really improved, especially that the government has allowed the unhampered deliveries of all cargoes. So all's well. At the moment.
So are you able to pick up from where you left off, given the initial sort of log jam, if you will, at the start of the lockdown?
Very much. We were able to not only resume our production, which allowed our people to go to our different facilities, but we were also able to deliver our chicken, our processed meats, to the different supermarkets and stores. So if you go to those stores today, you will find a lot of our products available everywhere.
So what is the status of your inventory of food products? How many months down the line have you got before you run out?
For example, for our chicken products, we have inventory that will last us for probably until August. And beyond that, as you know, we continue to produce chicken, and we are assuring the public that we will have chicken available until the end of the year. For canned goods, for example, we have ample inventory, and we continue to produce. We have products that will last us for the next 30 days, but as we continue to produce in our plants, we can produce because we have enough packaging materials and raw materials that will last us until the end of the year.
Talk to us about the production side. How is that coming along? Are you getting your raw materials with no delays?
There is no problem in the shipment of the raw materials, especially that cargoes are now allowed to deliver to the plants. Kathy, I have to tell you that one of the difficulties we're having is really in the production side, because the workers will have to report in the plants, which means that we have to provide them safety to allow them to stay in the plant. For example, in the Pure Foods plant in Cavite, where we need about 1,300 workers, we've asked the workers if they can stay inside the plants to protect them from the COVID-19. But at the same time, we cannot force our workers who are worried about their safety to come to work. So at any given time, our production would go from like 60% of capacity to 85% of capacity. But at the same time, I have to say that we are able to produce continuously that will allow us to have our products available until the end of the year.
Is there anything that the government can do at this point to ensure the continuity of your production line, given that worker shortage is an issue with just 60 to 80%, as you say, operating?
Well, in the area of delivery, which was really the major problem in the past couple of days, I think the government has really done something about it to ease the delivery. And so we don't have any problems anymore as far as the delivery is concerned, except for a few, but we're able to resolve on a day-to-day basis. In the area of labor, we're also working with the Department of Labor through Secretary Bebot, and we've assured our workers that we will provide them the needed safety measures. We have offered them incentives so that they will be able to come to the plant and produce as planned.
With the in-house consumption on the rise because people are staying home more and in-premise consumption off because of the lockdown, what is the impact? Is this having on overall sales? Has consumption merely shifted?
Yes, definitely, because there are now a lot of consumption from home. You know, in the beginning of the week, we've observed a lot of panic buying because I think the consumers were not assured that products will be available on a continuous basis, and because we were running out of products on the shelves because of the delivery problems that we were having. But I guess in the last few days, we've improved on that. We've come up with a statement that we have enough products, and we were assuring the consumers that we will have them available and for them not to panic. The biggest problem really is when the consumers begin to panic and they clean up the shelves and not allowing other people to buy. But that is not so, today. So things, I think, should be okay.
And what is the status of your production of disinfectant alcohol? Because I understand that San Miguel's committed to convert its Ginebra gin plant for this.
Yes, that is on continuous basis. As of now, Ginebra has already delivered about 20,000 liters of alcohol to about 41 government hospitals and about 240 government agencies. And we continue to produce the alcohol to help in the availability of the regular alcohol, which was running out in the supermarkets. So again, we'd like to assure the public that this alcohol will be available not only to the hospitals, to the checkpoints, but also to many of the local government agencies.
Butch, final point. I know that you've been distributing free food and drinks since the lockdown. Which areas have you reached, and where to next?
Well, mostly at this time, mostly in Manila, we have distributed a lot of our canned goods in hospitals, in the LGUs. We've distributed the canned goods, biscuits, milk to about 18 hospitals so far. We continue to do that. We've distributed also products in the local government units. We've distributed pandesal, for example, in depressed areas, like in homeless of Quezon City, the Mayang Lagi community, the Centro Cristo de Paris, San Isidro, Labrador, Holy Family dwellers, and so forth and so on. So we continue to do that, Kathy, making sure that our consumers, especially those who are in need, are able to get these very needed food items, and that we will continue to provide this, because this has been the commitment of San Miguel and Mr. Ang to the community.
All right. Well, thank you so much for keeping us up to speed. Butch Alejo of San Miguel Food and Beverage. Keep well, sir.
Thank you for having me, Kathy.